Well, it's great today to be joined by Phoebe Land. Phoebe is a member of the Waldham All Saints Primary School School Parliament, and she is also a recycling ambassador at the school. So, Phoebe, welcome. It's good to have you with us.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Now, can you tell us what class you're in, who your teachers are? Okay, so we're here today to talk about recycling in the school. Can you tell us, what does the school do to make people aware of rubbish and recycling?
So we have a parliament at our school, and we have a monthly parliament meeting. And there the teachers will tell us about different ways we could recycle and reuse and do try and help the world, and we will go back to our classes and we will tell our class and our teachers about what we've been told, so that they can feel like they're part of it and it's not just a couple of children in the school who are taking part in this.
Okay, so it's the whole school, each class has somebody at that parliament, do they?
Yes.
Okay, that's really good. What other things does the school do?
We might do the same in PowerPoints, where we'll finish the PowerPoint and we'll stand up in front of the class in maybe pairs, probably pairs, and present our PowerPoint to the class. We will also, another thing that I've done, at Forest School, we've got two teachers who run the Forest School. Talk to us about ways we can help the forest, and not just our school but the forest, and because we sometimes I went on a walk, for instance, once, and there was plastic and rubbish and sort of like fizzy drink cans everywhere, and there was glass a lot on the floor as well. So it's just they talk to us about how we can try to recycle these things instead of just dumping them on the forest floor. I got so inspired about what I've been told that I felt really passionate, and I made a blog, which I don't think many people know about, but I did make a blog about recycling and other big needs that there'll be and the projects. It won't be just recycling, it's also reusing as well. And in year four, the whole class in year four, we in one term we had all we really talked about was recycling, and we near the end of the term, where we normally do a creative project, we had to make a sea creature, and we were told to bring as many material, plastic and stuff from a recycling box or something where you keep your recycling, and bring as many in and make as many sea creatures as you can using this stuff. And one of my brothers, who is currently in year three, is also doing what I did in year four last year, and me and him both were and did read a book called The Day the Ocean Went Away, which, as you can guess by the title, the ocean went away because there was too much plastic. We not really study, but we look at ways how we can help the world better place and not have so much junk and plastic and pollution.
Okay, Phoebe, so it's great that the school are doing all this great recycling and really taking it seriously, but what more do you think the school could do in the future to make it bigger and better?
I think we could be more ambitious because we're not really, we're just recycling the usual stuff that everyone recycles because it's just stuff that people recycle and it's normal. But we could take a step further and try and recycle more stuff and a wider range of materials so that we're reducing the amount of stuff that's getting dumped in forests and places where animals are and might eat or and die. We do litter picks obviously in our school grounds, but it's only in our school grounds, and we could try and do litter picking in we could do it for a school ground. For the village as well, maybe once a term or something like that. Like a really big litter pick where a year, maybe a term, takes part and really tries to take out all that litter. We could do forest litter picks as well, different when we go to forest school. We could also, an idea I had was we could set up maybe a school blog or Purple Mash, which is a website, because obviously we can't tell each other ideas because we can't go to school. So we could set up a school blog and you have to go on there every day and it will be update different ideas of how we can recycle and reuse different materials. We could also talk a bit more about reusing because it's a lot of recycle and not really reuse. So we could talk more about that so that we're reusing and it doesn't even have to be recycled until a later day. Instead of just putting the posters up in our school where they just get seen by our school, maybe the odd people who visit, but we could put it up, we could put them up in the village or maybe people in the class who don't live in Walden or Peter's Village could take them home to where they are and put them up there. Another idea I had was we could get someone important in to talk about, someone who's really passionate about it. That could be a local MP, but someone who I thought just would be really good is a tele-naturalist called Steve Backshaw. He's really passionate about helping the world fight back from all this trouble that's happening. And he would be great to help the school maybe get some better and more ambitious ideas about helping the world. And the last idea I had was we could maybe because there are different schools near Walden, and we could maybe get in touch with schools or something, and maybe, I don't know, and set up a green school award scheme where you have to try and get the most, the least litter place, so that, and then that will be a fun way of trying to help people recycle and reuse and get rid of it.
That's great. Phoebe, thank you very much for sharing all of that and for being interviewed today. Thank you.